my sister encouraged me to work in Abu Dhabi. So she sponsored me to come visit first.
Okay.
And then she told me to try.
Okay.
Because she can see me that I don't have future in the Philippines.
Hi everyone. I'm Happy Jane Gumera from Abu Dhabi and this is my story.
I work as a housekeeping in the Shangri-La for 2 years, and then one of my boss here in Abu Dhabi, he was a sending for the task force. That time they recruit who those interested to work in Abu Dhabi. So I applied that one as a housekeeping. In the center of the coconut tree, we have a field.
Okay.
Then all the surroundings of our house is a coconut tree. So before we go to the mall, market, we need to climb the mountain. We need to pass the river.
Really?
Yeah.
Hi everyone, this is Marcel. I'm from Abu Dhabi and this is my story.
You know, for me it's very hard also. Because my father left us,
okay?
So only my auntie who sustained us. Like whenever I achieve something, like she support us. Three of us, like we are old ladies, so we are separate. So I am the one who's left.
Okay.
So my two sisters is separate with me. Actually, in my side, it's very difficult because my mom is very sick. You know,
right.
She's having a heart attack. She knows everything is well. Also.
Right.
So one of my sister, you know, I'm the one who left here in Abu Dhabi.
Right.
So she left because she lost job also.
Okay.
So she spent a lot of money there. So in the first place, I explained that I'm lying in the UK.
Right.
So I'm not sending support to them also.
Okay.
So my sister, she get upset to me. Like, I will forget you as my sister.
Right. Okay.
What you did to our mom.
Okay.
Yeah, you're just selfish like that.
I understand.
So it's very, you know,
yeah.
I cried a lot too, happy also. Yeah. It's like, please, just give me a 6 months.
Right.
Then she said, just message your sister, maybe you have misunderstood.
Yeah.
Because my mom just forgive your sister. Whatever happened, just forget that. Then I message her, just sorry, I said. Because, you know, she's always with me, honest. Like, she's investigating happy. It's like I'm lying. But happy, she just explained, yeah, she just paying in this agency. We have only 400 dirhams every month that we spend, like in our food, anything. We are not going out. We just always say no to anything so that we can process and so on. And then finally, she believed too happy also
right.
that I'm not lying.
Right.
Yeah, because how much our salary only? Then we are paying 6 months. Then she understand. Then we are okay now. Like
friends.
She's not happy to leave.
Yeah.
Now that you've got your visa, I'm sure it's not only your sister, I'm sure it's not only your mom or some friends. I'm sure there are a lot of people who doubted you during the entire process.
Yeah.
Now you're here, you are just a few hours away from your flight.
Yeah.
Yeah? What can you say to them? Marissa, go ahead.
You
what can you say to them?
Those people who did not believe us first. I know that there's a lot of doubt, but I'm not explaining to you, but I just want to say thank you because of your saying or because of your words. It makes me push to my
it made you do better.
Yeah, to do better.
Right.
To push my dream
right.
that I need to prove to you that it's not a fake, it's not a scam. That this visa agency is give me the best opportunity. Trust the process only. Yeah. Believe in yourself. Focus what you want to do. You know, whatever you started, just continue. And I don't know. Now I'm feeling like how he has changed my life. Really. It's like when how many days like I'm floating. I cannot imagine how I feel.
Right.
You know, I'm just lying down in my bed like this is it. Thank you to all the Ian's team, especially Sir Michael and Sir Ian. Now you changed my life. I would like to tell to everyone that trust the process and Ian will do the rest. Sir Ian and Sir Michael to give us the best opportunity that I have. Now I'm going to fly in UK. So this is it, my dream come true.
Yay!